I was walking that ribbon of highway. I looked above me, there in the skyway. I looked below me, in the golden valley. This land was made for you and me.
This land is yours.
Dust clouds rolling. A voice was sounding as the fog was lifting. This land was made for you and me.
Thank you.
walking that ribbon of highway. I looked above me, there in the skyway. I looked below me, in the golden valley. This land was made for you and me.
This land is yours.
Dust clouds rolling, a voice was sounding as the fog was lifting. This land was made for you and me.
This land is yours.
South in the land of cotton mills. National Geography Awareness Week spotlights the crucial role that geography plays in understanding the cultures and countries of our world. Recent political, economic, and environmental stories have drawn attention to momentous events around the world in China, Eastern Europe, South Africa, the Middle East, Central America, Japan, Antarctica, the Soviet Union. The world is changing and changing quickly. We as people and as a nation must understand these changes and their far-reaching consequences. This year, National Geography Awareness Week focuses on the news using the theme Geography, Window on a Changing World, by examining current events through a geographic perspective. Students will come to understand and appreciate the insights that study of geography can bring to their lives. This was a quote by Gilbert M. Grosvenor, President and Chairman of the National Geography. We're from the 7th grade West Intermediate School.
We're going to tell you some news about Wilmington.
But first, here's a brief list of facts from Wilmington.
Wilmington was incorporated in 1730.
Some shopping centers in Wilmington are Wilmington Plaza, Weber Terraces, and Station Place.
The population in Wilmington is 18,100.
The zip code is 0187.
The total area in Wilmington is 17.08 miles.
Some churches in Wilmington are St. Dorothy's, St. Elizabeth's, First Baptist, and St. Thomas. St. Dorothy's, St. Elizabeth's, First Baptist, and St. Thomas.
Some major factories in Wilmington are Fort Howard, formerly Sweetheart Plastics, and Diamond Crystal Salt.
This concludes the brief history of Wilmington, and now for the news. Burlington Ave Bridge now open. The Burlington Ave Bridge is now open. The bridge was closed because of signs of deterioration. First, just the lane of the bridge was closed, but then the condition of the bridge just got worse, so the Wilmington Department of Public Works was forced to close the whole bridge. The closed bridge diverted traffic over a rickety wooden bridge. The bridge was blocked off for a month, and then the construction began. The workers were busy tearing down the bottom of the old bridge and respiking and tarring the new bottom. The bridge was supposed to open Monday, November 5th, but it opened 3 days earlier on Friday, November 2nd.
On November 7th, Jim Masili was named state representative for the 13th year in a row for the Middlesex Valley. He beat newcomer Kevin Sodera by a 987-vote margin in Wilmington.
At the Regional Health Center in Wilmington, there will be a walk-in for the handicapped. The reason for the handicapped walk-in is that they need to offer more parking for the handicapped. This happened a couple of days ago.
Wilmington. Kimberly A. Carbone was awarded the American Educational Foundation Achievement for Massachusetts Society of Certified Public Accountants, Incorporated. She attends the University of Lowell and expects to receive a bachelor's degree in accounting in June of 1991. Massachusetts Society of Certified Public Accountants, Incorporated is a state professional organization for certified public accountants. More than 7,600 members. Carbone was awarded the Educational Foundation Achievement Award of Massachusetts Society for Certified Public Accountants, Incorporated. She attends the University of Lowell and expects to receive a bachelor's degree in accounting. Professional organization of certified public accountants, more than 7,600 members in the public practice, industry, government, and education.
To by National Geography Awareness Week, and this year's theme is Window on a Changing World. And we would like to give thanks to Costa, Tom Gately,
Mr. Stone, Jennifer Hunt, Kristen Roach,
Katie Sinesi,
Laurie Blizzard, Mike O'Brien,
Sean DeCoste,
and Doug Olinda for all their help in making this
and now,
possible.
And now, here is Jennifer Hunt and Katie Sinesi.
This shows the picture of the Western Community. with the award that he received for the second place in the map, the political Europe map, he gets this certificate, and he also gets a $5 gift certificate from McDonald's. Kristen gets the first place award for map making.
I'm in the cafeteria of the West Intermediate School, and we're celebrating National Geography Awareness Week. And I have with me two young boys that were supposed to speak over the intercom this morning, but didn't get a chance, and so they want to be on camera this afternoon to tell you a little bit about what we're doing. First, we have Eric Morin. And Eric, what's so important about this week?
Well, it's a time, Mr. Stone, when we look at the world and see what's going on, and we can find out any way we can help it.
Okay. Good, thank you, Eric. And Ben, just what are these students doing behind us at the present time?
This is our class wham and taco party.
Okay. What is the significance of that taco party?
It's on a cultural region, and that's the foods that they eat.
Right. What's the cultural region that they're... What's the cultural region that it's on?
Mexico.
Mexico is a part of that cultural region, Latin America, and we'll take you on a tour very shortly of all of the different cultural areas of the world that are found here in the cafeteria, and the students here at the West are going to take part in a contest to see which class can come up with the right answers to a series of questions that we have for them. Okay, that will happen in just a short while. Okay, we're here this afternoon to celebrate National Geography Awareness Week, and how we're going to do it this period is to see just how well you people have been able to gather information this week on 8 of the cultural regions of the world based upon your textbook. I'm going to ask the group leaders from each section to come up in just a moment and get a sheet that has the 8 regions listed on it, and then a series of questions that you have to answer. You will have to go to all 8 of the cultural booths, looking at their maps and looking at the items that are on the table to get the information that you need. The first class, as a class now, the first class to get all of the correct answers during this period will get an extra 100 to start the second term. Okay, so it's only the first class that finishes. It's not every class. So don't give out answers to people that are not within your class. You've got 3 teams in each class, all of them working together to try to get the answers, okay? Have some fun with it, but go to the different tables. The teachers will be stationed around to help with crowd control. But when you go to a table, just make sure that you look at the things that are there, try to gather the information that you can, and then go to the next table. I'm going to ask the group leaders to stay here at the tables seated so that your group will always know where you are. They can come back with the answers, and you can give them another question to try to go seek out the answer to. Okay? Okay, first of all, I would like the 3 group leaders from section 105 to come up, please. Okay, good luck, gentlemen. Section 104, the 3 team leaders from 104, please. You may stay with your team, or you may go with someone else in your class for these. Section 103. Oh, she hasn't. Section 102. Turn and face the camera on your way back so we get to see you on the TV. Okay. And section 101.
We don't have one. We don't have a lead up.
Yeah, you did. Okay. Take them to. Okay. 101, Elizabeth has you. Okay, let me have your attention now, please. Listen up. Philip? Now, you only have a little over 20 minutes to complete this. So check in with your group leader, find out what the sheet is asking for, and then go to it, all right? Okay, good luck. Go ahead. To two young gentlemen that have an interesting product here that they will tell you a little bit about. First of all, tell us your name, and then what are you doing?
I'm David Stewart, and I'm cutting up kiwi.
Where's this kiwi come from?
New Zealand.
How's it taste, David?
Kind of sour, but kind of tastes like a banana also.
And this is?
Pita.
Pita what?
Minicello.
Okay, Pita, and what are you doing here today?
I'm helping Dave.
Okay, have you tasted any of this yet? Yeah. Good or not?
It's good.
Okay, let's go on to the next. We have two young ladies here that have made a mess of this whole area, but they're going to tell us a little bit about what they accomplished this afternoon. What did you do here? Now, first of all, let us know your name and what you've done.
Look at the camera.
Hi, Leanne Harris, and Tracy and I made tacos for our social studies class because we're doing Latin America.
Okay. How were they, Tracy?
They were good.
What goes into a taco?
Meat, cheese, lettuce, sauce if you want it.
Tomatoes.
Okay. Well, it looks like you had a good time making them anyway. Did you? Okay. Okay. Thank you very much, girl. Here with Nicole Nelson, who's the first place finisher in our poster contest for this week's National Geography Awareness Week. And we're going to ask her a few questions about the booth that she is responsible for today. First of all, what is the region that you're dealing with, Nicole?
Latin America.
Can you tell us about some of the things that you have on the table here that represent Latin America?
Okay. This is a Mexican sombrero in maracas. We have some pictures here of the natives. Down here is an Inca man with his boat. They still, native Incas still make these kind of boats now. Some pottery. We have a couple books, and they're different flags of all the different countries of South America. Over here is a picture of Mexico and what some of the people look like. And then behind me is a piñata. And over here is a map of South America.
Okay, you notice you also have a leftover taco here. Are you going to eat that later on, or? Okay, thank you, Nicole. Yeah, working very hard on the questions for the contest. And how are we doing so far? Let's see. Kristen, how many have you got done?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
You're finding it easy then, I guess.
No.
It's like all my quizzes, it's hard. This is Katie, by the way. And Jennifer.
Hello.
And Tim.
Hi.
Tom is working hard over here.
Hi.
That's the first time Tom has been speechless all year. And, okay, Keith we have working on his own here. How are you doing so far, Keith?
All right, fine.
Group 3 might have quit on us.
Group 3 seems to have quit on them so far, but they'll make a comeback. Oh, he made a comeback. Okay. Well, good luck, and we'll talk to you later on. Okay, we are here with Mr. Spriggs, and we are talking about National Geography Awareness Week, and what you had just said was very important, Mr. Spriggs. Could you repeat that for us, please?
Certainly. You asked about the importance of National Geography Week. I said I think it's good for the students to learn that there's a culture, a geography outside of Wilmington, outside of Massachusetts, outside of New England. I also think when they study a lot of these countries, a lot of them go back into their own culture. They talk to their parents or grandparents. I know when I've talked about certain animals that are used as foods, many of the students can relate to their grandparents as to using certain cultural dishes, certain ethnic dishes. The Italians, for instance, cooking tripe, the Middle Eastern regions, cooking the certain foods, the grape leaves and different foods like that. And they get more into the culture away from the foods. And I find that it's good for the students to know about that.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Spiggs. Okay, boy, that was of you just get around me. Just get around me for a moment so you can be on camera. Okay. Just stay right in here. Come on in, John. Okay, from the West Intermediate School, I'd like you all to just, on the count of three, wish everybody a happy National Geography Awareness Week. One, two, three.
Happy National Geography Week!
Okay, thank you.